When I was a kid in the late 60s and early 70s, Johnny Whitaker was a pretty darn big deal when it came to child stars. Throughout my formative years, he seemed like he was everywhere. And because he was a local boy, a kid from Utah, my home state, well, that made him, at least for a little while, seem extra special. It all started with a little television program called Family Affair. Required viewing in my home, heartwarming and funny, Family Affair was, at least in part, so popular because of the pairing of Anissa Jones and Johnny Whitaker as twins, Buffy and Jody. They weren't originally supposed to be twins, but when the casting director saw those two kids together, well, scripts were rewritten and the rest, as they say, is television history. For me, I liked everything about the show except for that dang doll. Man, I hated Mrs. Beasley. Much like clowns, she just freaked me out. I'm quite certain that the inspiration for all of those Chucky movies started with this deceptively innocent-looking doll. Really, not so innocent-looking if you dig a little deeper. Just look at those eyes. Those evil eyes. Who in their right mind thought this was an appropriate doll for Buffy to play with? To make matters worse, my sister Valerie got a Mrs. Beasley doll for her birthday one year. I can't remember what I did with it, but let's just say she wasn't around to terrorize me for long. Anyway, let's get back to Johnny Whitaker. Like I said, this cat was everywhere. Disney movies, a Christmas special called The Littlest Angel, and of course that Tom Sawyer musical. I loved that movie, and like many of the best movies, it inspired me to go back and read the book. After that, Johnny hit his peak, at least for me, starring in Sid and Marty Krofft's Sigmund and the Sea Monsters. Saturday mornings were pretty awesome in the 70s, and the Krofft brothers, well, they had a lot to do with that. Sigmund and the Sea Monsters may not have been their best show, but it was still pretty darn good. The show also had a really catchy theme song called Friends that turned into a minor hit for Johnny. For a brief, shining moment way back then, this guy was even bigger than the Osmonds. But then, as so often happens with child stars, things slowed down a bit for Johnny. Okay, let's be truthful. They pretty much grounded to a halt. And that was okay because Johnny had other plans anyway. He served as a missionary for the Mormon Church in Portugal, and then returned home and went to Brigham Young University where he got a degree in communications. He even got married, settled down, got a job away from the limelight. It was a wise move because things weren't going well for many of his Family Affair co-stars. His TV twin sister, Buffy, Anissa Jones, she died from a drug overdose. Brian Keith committed suicide. And Sebastian Cabot? Well, he suffered multiple strokes and died at the all-too-early age of 59. And on top of that, Kathy Garver, who played Sissy on Family Affair, well, things became tense between her and Johnny. There were a number of reasons, but it's too bad because there are times when it's nice to be able to lean on a friend for comfort and support. Oh, and Johnny's marriage? It fell apart. It was a tough time for this former star. A tough time indeed that found him walking down a dark path with drug and alcohol addiction. Yep, it was a far different life from the one that he had imagined for himself many years ago. In the early 2000s, a revamped version of Family Affair hit the airwaves. Sadly, it was not a hit and would not provide any sort of real comeback opportunity for either Johnny or Kathy. Only semi-related, at least they softened up Mrs. Beasley a little bit. Not scary at all anymore. Nice job, TV guys. At least you got one thing right. And although Johnny and Kathy made an appearance together at the TV Land Awards in 2007, the hard feelings, unfortunately, still seem to exist between these two stars. It would take years for a true reconciliation to take place. More on that in a minute. Let's get back to Johnny's troubles with drugs and alcohol. A few years before Johnny's TV Land appearance, his family held an intervention and shared with him their concern about his welfare. They didn't want to see him go down the same dark path that his castmates, as well as many others, had ventured down in the past. They forced him to acknowledge his addictive behaviors and he agreed to get help. Johnny has been clean and sober for more than a decade now. When possible, he speaks publicly about his own trials and has become a certified drug addiction counselor. At long last, Johnny has found a way, a different way, but still a way to rise again. And things have continued to improve for Mr. Whitaker. In 2016, Johnny made a cameo appearance on the Amazon Prime reboot of Sigmund and the Sea Monsters. A sharp-eyed viewer will also notice the Croft brothers, yep, Sid and Marty, in another cameo during the episode. During that same year, Johnny traveled to Kathy Garver's home and publicly apologized for past actions. Having watched the clip on YouTube a few times now, I'm not certain that Kathy was ready for Johnny's surprise appearance, but I do believe that his heart was in the right place, and that sometimes, well, it just has to suffice. So that's it. One more picture from Family Affair. Oh, there's that darn Mrs. Beasley doll. Even Jody seems freaked out in this scene, and with good reason. That doll just creeps me out. Anyway, please share your memories in the comment section. And while you're at it, I'd love a thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. And I would be absolutely honored if you would consider subscribing to my little channel. I talk about music, movies, and television, mostly from the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s. You know, the good stuff. But most importantly, and as always, thank you so much for watching.